So now you see, in case of insect, which kind of mouth parts are there? If you tell broadly, according to the food, how many kind of mouth parts are there? Which kind of mouth parts are there in case of insect? According to the foods, which kind of mouth parts are there?
Sir, biting chewing type, sir, pursing and sucking type, sir, swallowing type.
Okay. Any other? How many
Sir,
food
chewing
types?
and lapping type.
Okay, good. Okay. So you tell me now, how many kind of food is there for insect? If you categorize broadly, then how many
Two
kind of
types.
foods? Okay, what are those? It is written in your slide, na? You tell. One is solid, another one is liquid.
Liquid type.
Yes or no? For solid kind of food material, like your grains, whatever you are storing in the storage godown, or your plants present in the plant field, yes or no? Again, those leaves, those fruits, okay, those are your solid food material, which upon which the insect will feed. What is liquid food? What is liquid food?
Nectar, sir.
Nectar is one thing. If you take your butterflies, your moth, then honeybees, then nectar is there. Now suppose some bugs are there, some thrips are there. For them, what is the liquid food? The plants are, yes or no? They will insert their stylet into the plant, okay, and from their xylem and phloem you can take. From that they will suck this up. Getting my point? From their phloem tissue, from their vascular bundle, they will just take up the sap, which is containing the nutrients for the plant. So the nutrients will come into the insect. Yes or no? Getting my
Yes,
point?
sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So based on that, the insect is divided into two parts. Basically, one is mandibulate, one is hostelate. So in mandibulate, this biting and chewing type will come. And in case of hostelate, all others will come. Piercing and sucking, then rasping and sucking, then whatever, chewing and lapping, siphoning, sponging, all will come. Okay. So for solid food material, biting and chewing, and for rest, other kind of mouth parts are there. Again, in case of some insect like your sucking pest, they have filter chamber, and in case of solid feeders, they have gizzard. So what are these things we'll discuss in this chapter? Okay. So do you know what is alimentary canal? I think you all have the biology in your plus two. Yes or no? What is alimentary canal? Those things I know, you know, I think. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that means alimentary canal means that is starting from the mouth cavity up to the anus. Yes or no? The whole, you can tell the whole structure for the digestive system where consumption will be there, absorption will be there, digestion will be there, again, excretion will be there. This whole alimentary canal will be there to which some other physiological system may be adapt. Okay, so this alimentary canal in case of insect, okay. That is divided into three region. You can see that is divided into three region. One is stomatium, then your that is your foregut. Okay, first you see the common name, that is foregut, anterior part, foregut, then midgut, then hindgut. Okay, foregut is also known as stomatium, midgut is known as mesenteron, hindgut is known as proctodium. Understood? Again, for this midgut, that is known as mesenteron, stomach, and also ventriculus. Getting my point? Okay, it may come in
Yes.
the exam. Okay, divided into foregut, midgut, hindgut, with synonym like your stomatium, mesenteron, and proctodium. Okay, so these are the three basic division of alimentary canal. Okay, so you see this one, this foregut, the anterior side end, and this hindgut, the posterior side end. Okay, these two are your ectodermal in origin, produced or outside, and in case of midgut, that is endodermal in origin. Understood? It may come in the exam. Foregut and hindgut are ectodermal in origin, and midgut is endodermal in origin. Okay, so if you compare in between the sucking pest and in between the phytophagous insect, like your plant feeding insect, those are the solid feeders. If you take, okay, in case of the solid feeder, they have the higher complexity. Okay, higher complexity of the alimentary canal, and that is that much longer also. okay, if you compare with the sucking paste. Why? Because there the consumption is different, the digestion process is different, everything is different. Okay, now first coming to your foregut or stomatium, here you see foregut or stomatium. So where it is starting, you see, this is the foregut, then midgut, then hindgut. This structure, not this one. Okay, this one, foregut, midgut, then hindgut, this one. Okay, this is the structure. So this foregut, okay, it will start with the mouth cavity. Here you see, this is the mouth cavity. From this the foregut will start and it will end with the gizzard. Here the gizzard will be there. At gizzard portion it will be ending, okay, mouth cavity to the gizzard, which is known as proventriculus. After proventriculus, ventriculus will come, that is your mesenteric or midgut. So anyway, we will start from one by one. So this foregut is again divided into your mouth cavity, pharynx, oesophagus, crop and gizzard. How many parts are there? 1 2 3 4 5 Mouth cavity, pharynx, oesophagus, crop and gizzard. So what is mouth cavity? Am I audible and visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is mouth cavity? Mouth cavity is the cavity formed by the mouth parts. Mouth part in the sense, your labrum, you take labium, you'll take maxilla, mandible, whatever, and the hypopharynx, by their combination, but inside they are making a hollow tubular structure, that is known as what, your mouth cavity. Again, to this mouth cavity, hypopharynx and salivary glands will be open. Okay, what is their use, we'll discuss in the last slide. Okay, then coming to the pharynx, okay, it is the region between the mouth cavity, this one, this mouth cavity, and the oesophagus. That means mouth cavity is there, oesophagus is there, and they are defining the pharynx, just like a story. What is that? Pharynx is present in between mouth cavity and oesophagus. Yes or no? Story kind. Yes or no? Just a prefix, suffix, then over. Okay. Then this is nothing but the transportation channel. Just this is somewhat dilated or expanded. That's why the role is there. That is known as the pharynx. But in case of annelids or in case of some other arthropods, they have some different use in the excretory system. That is different thing. Okay, enteronephric, nephritic, there's so many things are there, and that is not your concern. So at that time, pharynx is important. Okay, now coming to the oesophagus, you see, after the expander, first it's narrow, then expanded, then again narrow. This narrow structure is what, your oesophagus. It is present in between the pharynx and crop. The next part is crop. So it is present in between the pharynx and crop. Okay, it is also an organ of transportation through which the food will be transported from pharynx to the crop. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now coming to the crop, you see, crop is a sac-like structure. Yes or no? It is in the dilated form, expanded form, and it is helpful in storing the food. That means before passing the food into the gizzard, where some partial digestion will occur in this gizzard, before that they will store the food in the crop. That means the first food which is already been entered, that will be digested or partially digested, then transported into midgut. In this time, what will happen? The excessive food material will be kept in this crop. So what this use of gizzard? Slowly they will collect the food from the crop, partially digest that one, then submit it to the midgut. Understood? So this is the role of crop, that is mainly for storage of the food material. Understood up to this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now coming to the gizzard, you see, this is the gizzard. Okay, gizzard, the constricted part. You see, this is dilated part, and this is the constricted part. Okay, so here what will happen? This is the constricted part of the alimentary canal, and here some layers are there, like innermost intima layer, then epithelial layer, then basement membrane, then longitudinal muscle, then circular muscle. Like this, the membranes are there. That is not important, but you should know that in case of the foregut and hindgut, they have intima layer, inner intima layer, but in case of your midgut, that is, they are having this inner peritrophic membrane. What is the difference? I will tell you in the midgut. Okay, so in this cuticular intima layer of gizzard, they have teeth like denticles or projection, which will help in grinding the food material. That's why I told you somewhat partial or pre-digestion will occur in this gizzard. Okay, in some insect like honeybees, in honeybees, what they collect? Honeybees collect what? nectar. Yes or no? So while collecting nectar, sometimes what happens, also some pollens or some minor particles of pollens will be collected with this nectar. Okay, so at that time what will happen, so this gizzard, they will be somewhat modified in case of honeybees, which is known as what, your honey stopper, you can tell, or honey stainer, where what will happen, those pollen will be again separated into crop and only the nectar will enter into the midgot. Understood? Pollen will be separated at the crop through this gizzard. Gizzard will act as a stainer at that time. Okay, and the nectar will enter into or flow into the midgot. That's why it is known as honey stopper in case of your honeybees. The gizzard is known as honey stopper. Okay, why? Because it separates the pollen from the nectar. Okay, so now what will happen, after the food will enter into this gizzard, it has to move to midgot. Yes or no? But suppose what will happen, the insect is moving downwards in the plant, and if that will be a totally hollow tube, then what will happen, the food material will again push out. Yes or no? That's why in every guts, in foregut, midgut and hindgut, in each junction one valve is there. Okay, in case of foregut, that is known as what, your what, stomodial valve. Okay, which is surrounded by the gastric or hepatic cavity. You see here the valve will be there inside, but this is the gastric or hepatic cavity. Understood clearly? Getting my point? In between this foregut and midgut, one valve is there, which is known as the stomodial valve, and around with these finger like things, you see, is it visible, my mouse pointer, is it visible? This is the gastric or hepatic cavity. Okay, it is surrounding the stomodial valve. What is the use of stomodial valve? To function unidirectional food flow. That means the food will go from the foregut to midgut, but it won't return back. That is the function of stomodial valve. Understood clearly?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now coming to your next part, that is your midgut or mesenteron. Okay, midgut or mesenteron. So after the food will completed or bypass through this or pass through this foregut, it will enter into the midgut. Okay, and this foregut will open to the midgut through this stomodial. This one is important. The synonym of stomodial valve is known as your cardiac valve. Note it down. Cardiac valve and stomodial valve are same. Okay, only synonym. Okay, you should not get confused. As I have told you, in that, in case of foregut and hindgut, which is the inner layer? In case of foregut and hindgut, which one is the
intima?
But in case of your midgut, that is your peritrophic membrane. It may come in the exam. Okay. Especially what happens in this midgut, the exact digestion process will occur. And suppose one insect is a solid feeder and that is consuming this solid food. Okay, so there what will happen, while digestion, the solid food particles may affect the epithelial cell of the insect. Okay, so for protecting those you see, this is the structure, this is the layer, and suppose in this line the food material will be there. So what is the function of peritrophic membrane? This peritrophic membrane will prevent this solid food material from damaging the epithelial cells. That is the function of your peritrophic membrane. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Really,
yes, sir.
Understood? Okay. Okay, excuse me. Now coming to what are the other function of this peritrophic membrane. You see, suppose this membrane is there. So whatever the epithelial or whatever the cell secretion will be there, they must go into the midgut. Yes or no? You see here. Okay, just a minute. Suppose here the peritrophic membrane is there. Okay, somewhere. Okay, inner layer. So this must be somewhat permeable to those enzymes or digestive enzymes which will be secreted into the midgut. Then only the enzymes will act with the solid food material and they will digest that particular food item. Okay, then only the digestion will occur. Yes or no? That means the peritrophic membrane must be permeable to those digestive enzymes and the product of digestion. What is the meaning of this product of digestion?
Expiration.
They are digesting something means they will acquire the energy, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So those things must be product, yes or no? Product is again divided into two parts. One is the excretory product, another one is the metabolism product, yes or no? Metabolized product will enter through the peritrophic membrane to the cells and it will be totally used in the physiological process, and the excretory product will be excreted out through this hind gut. Okay. But it is absent in case of your sucking paste, because in case of sucking paste or sucking insect, you should not know paste, you should know insect. Okay. So what is sucking insect? In case of sucking insect, the food material will be liquid. So there is no chance of damaging the epithelial cell. And that's why the peritrophic membrane is not developed in this case of sap-sucking insect. Why understood? Why absent? Why they're absent? Understood? Okay. Okay. So again, the epithelial layer, this one is the epithelial cell. So here the epithelial layer will be there, second layer. It is composed of three type of cells: columnar cells, regenerative cells, then goblet cells. What is columnar cells? These are the cells responsible for secretion of the digestive enzymes. In this cell, some series of microvilli will be there, finger-like projection will be there, from which what will happen? The digestive enzymes will be released. And through peritrophic membrane, as that is permeable to those digestive enzymes, they will enter into the midgut. They will secrete here and enter into the midgut. Understood? Okay. And they are arranged in a brass border or honeycomb border, just like your honeycombs, they will be arranged. Understood this one? Brass border or honeycomb border? These things understood?
Yes, sir.
What you understood? Tell.
Like a brass type manner.
What? They are arranged like what?
Sir, honeycomb manner and brass type manner.
Huh? What is the meaning of that? I know that
sir,
is.
Increases the absorption area, sir.
Yes.
What? Who is telling what? Two members were telling. Tell.
Sir, it increases absorption area of food materials. Because the brush border.
Okay, my question is, they are arranged in honeycomb border or brush border. What do you mean by that? Tell.
Is the microvilli are arranged in the honeycomb?
Not only. No, this are coming zero.
Sir, the microvilli are arranged in honeycomb or brush border.
You see, whatever written, I know what you understood. I am asking. I am not asking you any questions for which I will give you mark. Not like that. I am just asking you what do you understood from that. That's all. See, in case of honeycomb border, this or your what is the other synonym? The brass border. Okay, such kind of structure will be there. Okay, this kind of structure or
parallel type arrangements.
Yes. Okay, like this, it will be there. Through which the enzymes will be secreted. Understood? Okay. This is not in case of exactly insect digestive system, I am not telling you. But in case of digestive system, if you go for columnar cells, this will be the cells. Like this, it will enter. Why it is known as honeycomb border? You see, in case of honeycomb also, such kind of things will be there. Okay. Okay, if you put it inverted, yes or no, it will be looking like just exact of that, yes or no? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, if you go for lateral side of honeycomb, it will come. Okay, here you see. Clear? Understood? Why it is known as honeycomb border? You see. Okay. This is the lateral view. This is the frontal view, but this is the lateral view. Getting my point or not? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay, why this is brass border or honeycomb border? Okay. I hope you understood that one. Now coming to your next is regenerative cells. That means when those columnar cells will be older, they have secreted their enzymes and that is now has to be removed. to replace that one, these regenerative cells will be secreted or produced. Okay, they will just replace the columnar cells which are involved in the secretion of enzymes. If those regenerative cells will be grouped, that means they will be arranged in groups, just like the pictures I have shown you, they will be known as what, your nidhi. It may come in the exam. Note it down. What is nidhi? When regenerative cells are in groups, arranged in groups, that is known as what, your nidhi. It may come in the exam. Understood? Note it down. Definitely this question will come in the exam. Okay. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then now last one is your goblet cells. Okay, which is mainly helpful for storage and excretion. This is not important. Okay, anyway, so we are discussing about your epithelial layer. Okay, this should be there in your mind. Okay, don't just think that somewhere columnar cells is there, somewhere nidhi is there, not like that. You should know what is the subcategories. Okay, where we study columnar cells, if that is epithelial layer, where we study epithelial layer, no, in the midgut, in midgut epithelial layer is there, in all the guts epithelial layer is there, but peritrophic membrane is only present in case of midgut. Like that, you just try to connect, link up the things. Okay, you should not read like a machine. Okay, you should know where it is there, why it is there, how it is there. Okay, at least whatever is possible, you should go through that. Okay, understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now coming to your hind gut or proctodium, you see this one, this is the hind gut region. Okay. So this is lined inside by again intima layer and more permeable than that of foregut. Okay, as compared to foregut, here the intima layer are more permeable. Just like your foregut and midgut, one valve is there. In between your midgut and hindgut also one valve is there, which is known as pyloric valve. But that one is which valve? Valve present in between foregut and midgut is known as
cardiac valve.
Stromodial or cardiac valve, yes or no? But in case of your midgut and hindgut, that is known as your pyloric valve. Okay, but internally the guts are similar, is that of foregut and hindgut, these are similar. Okay, but hindgut is divided into three regions, namely ileum, colon and rectum. Ileum, colon and rectum, we see the picture. Okay, here ileum will be there, you see. This is the foregut, then this is the midgut. This is the junction of midgut and hindgut. Okay, here the ileum will be there. Ileum, colon, then rectum. This is the whole structure. This is rectum, but ileum and colon will be there. Okay, which is not leveled here. Okay, lastly, excretory output structure will be there. That is anus. Okay, so the junction of this midgut and hindgut at the anterior part of your hindgut. Okay, what will be there? These Malpighian tubules will be there. Again, your, which one? Your pyloric valve will be there. Okay. So now, if you go for ileum, colon and rectum, first is your ileum. This is the small intestine present here at the junction, near the junction. Okay. A tube-like structure that appear as the pouch in case of scarabids. In scarabids, what is happening? They are feeding on a different material, feeding material. They are the scavengers. So for them, the digestion requires some other kind of microorganism, like your protozoa you take, or some cellulose feeding insect organisms you take. They harbor that different kind of microorganisms, for which what will happen, their ileum is extended, not in case of other insect. Then coming to your colon, okay, it may or may not be present. If present, that leads to rectum. It will be somewhat non-articulated. That means you cannot distinguish easily between your rectum and colon. Okay. Now, so just like your midgut, in case of your rectum also some different kind of papilla will be there, rectal papilla, which is having some pads, like your 3 to 6 in number, in between this. Okay. Just like your gastric cavity, here also some rectal pads will be there, that is 3 to 6 in number, that is involved generally for your reabsorption of water salt from the fecal matter. That means the excreted material will come like this. So in this rectum, what will happen? Again, from those excreted product, again from those waste material, again reabsorption of water and salt will be there because they have the capacity. That means again from their excreta, they are deriving some amount of nutrients that could be lost that can be reabsorbed. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So this is all about your foregut, midgut, and hindgut. So in foregut, what are the parts? In foregut, what are the parts? Tell. I should not show you this slide. Huh? Tell. First is
mouth cavity.
Mouth cavity. Then
pharynx.
Then
gizzard.
Top and gizzard. Then coming your valve. That is your stomatal or cardiac valve. Then comes your midgut. Yes or no? In midgut again, what is there? Peritrophic membrane is important. Then this columnar cell, regenerative cells, and goblet cells. You have to remember some more points are there, but not that is not important for you. Okay. Then coming to your hindgut, you should know about this peritrophic membrane. Okay. Then third one is your what? Hindgut, where you have to remember ileum, colon, and rectum. Also your pyloric valve. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is all about your digestive system. Then coming to somat, your salivary glands generally present in case of your sucking insect. Yes or no? These are the pair of gland, not only sucking all, but still, especially in the sucking insect. Okay. So these are the pair of glands secretes salivary juice. Okay. Open at the base of, you see, this is the mouth cavity. Okay. This is the hypopharynx. So near the hypopharynx junction here, these salivary glands are there, through which the saliva will be secreted out. Okay. They contains the enzymes like your amylase, lipase, protease for digesting protein, protease for digesting lipid, lipase for digesting amylase, that is amylases. Okay. Like that thing. Okay. But never cellulase, because cellulase means what? Those insects which feed on the wood material, which feed on the your book bindings, just like your termites, for them this cellulase is required, which will be present in the hindgut, in the ileum and rectum, not here. Okay, because they will associate with the different protozoa, symbiotic association will be there. That is not important here. Okay, so again, in case of silkworm, what will happen? They will produce the silk with the two kind of protein, that is your fibroid and serine, produced from this salivary glands only. Okay. They also secrete anticoagulants in case of blood sucking insect like your mosquito. Okay. So this is all about your salivary gland. Then coming to your filter chamber, this is important. Okay. What I want to tell you is, in case of sucking insect, what will happen? They are feeding on the plant sap. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in case of those sucking pest, especially on this sap-sucking insect and infective insect, what will happen? Damaging insect, they will suck more amount of sap. Okay. In their in a daily basis. So what will happen? So many kind of sucrose material and all those sugary material will be consumed through this sap. Okay. And if that will go in this midgut to digest that much of liquid material, liquid plant sap, they require more energy, more digestive enzymes, more everything, but it is not required by the insect. They are very minute insect, even very, very minute. Okay. So they can be seen in neck dive, but very minute. So for their survival, this much amount of food is not required. So what they are doing? What they will do from this junction of foregut and midgut, okay, here one bypass structure will be attached directly to the junction of your midgut and hindgut. So here what will happen, the food will directly bypass to the hindgut without entering into the midgut. If they will enter, unnecessarily that will utilize the extra amount of digestive enzymes to just prevent the loss of that one. What they are doing, they are bypassing the extra amount of your food material, which is coming out as the honeydew in case of aphids through their cornicles. In the midgut in hemipelan insect, this is present, sucking insect. Okay. So how they are attached? They are bound to either posterior part of the midgut or the anterior part of the hindgut in the Malpighian tubules. Okay, they will start from anterior midgut and they will attach to the posterior midgut or to the anterior hindgut in Malpighian tubules. So here what will happen? Whatever the excess fluid is there, including the sugar in the food of the soccer insect, they will directly bypass from the anterior part of the midgut to the hindgut without entering into the midgut. Okay, so what is the advantage here? Excessive dilution of this hemolymph and enzymes, okay, will be prevented and it will facilitate the better enzymatic activity. Okay, so in aphids, this honeydew secreted after passing through the filter chamber is one of the example. Understood clearly?
Yes.
Okay, so this is about your filter chamber. Okay, now coming to your some of the digestion, what are the steps involved in the digestion process? That is ingestion, then transportation, then digestion, okay, then absorption. So what is ingestion? The food has to be ingested, yes or no? Again, the food must be partially digested in some insect, okay, with the help of the salivary enzymes produced from the salivary glands. Okay, an insect like your fluid feeder, which is known as also carnivorous insect, okay, hemipteran insect, this aphid and all, their digestion occurs outside the intestine by a process which is known as what, your extra intestinal digestion or extra oral digestion. That means digestion will be done partially out of the body or out of the intestine. That is known as what, your extra oral digestion, so that it will be helpful for them for this digestion in the midgut. Okay, next is your transportation. Here what will happen, that is the food will be transported from the pharynx, then to the esophagus, then to the crop. Like this it will move by this peristatic movement. Okay, then it will be stored in the crop, then it will be entered into the gizzard, followed by to the midgut. In gizzard again some partial digestion will occur in case of solid feeders. Then coming to your digestion, it will enter into the midgut. Okay, then this epithelial cell will produce the enzymes. The enzymes will come to the midgut through this peritrophic membrane due to their permeability. Then this protease molecule will break the amino acids. Then carbohydrates will be hydrolyzes. Okay, hydrolyzes, that is the enzyme, will break the carbohydrates into mono and disaccharides. Similarly, lipase will break the lipid material into fatty acids and glycerol. So such kind of breakdown of the larger particle into smaller particles will be there. Okay, so again you see in case of termite, as I have told you, here what will happen, the digestion will take place in a colon, in the colon, okay, ileum, colon and rectum. In the colon the digestion will occur. How? They will harbor some of the microorganisms like your protozoa. Okay, protozoa will secrete the enzyme cellulase which will digest the cellulose material. That means termites will feed on the wood material. In the wood, cellulose is there, but cellulose cannot be digested by this protease, carbohydrates, lipase present in the midgut. So the digestion will occur in the colon, in the hindgut. How? In the colon they will harbor the protozoans, and those protozoans will secrete this cellulase which will digest the cellulose material. Understood clearly?
Yes sir.
Okay, similarly in case of scarabid, they have the bacteria as the symbionts. In case of wood feeders, they have the keratin. Okay, the keratin will be digested by the alkaline pH of the midgut. Okay, facilitated by the alkaline pH of the midgut. In case of cloth moth, this keratinase will be there, produced by the protozoans, which will digest the keratin material present in the cloth. Okay, because they will feed on the cloths. Then coming to your absorption, okay, here what will happen, from the midgut, whatever the digestion has been occurred and whatever the nutrients has been produced, they will be absorbed through this